Hello, dear chess lovers. Today I want to show you a new game between Sigbert Tarrasch and Romberg. This game was played in 1893. When this game was played, Dr. Tarrasch was 31 years old. In this game, Dr. Tarrasch gives his opponent an advantage, rook advantage, but won this game with great brilliancy. Let's see this party. Tarrasch, white pieces, played e4, black e5, Tarrasch, knight f3, black knight c6, Tarrasch d4, scotch game, e takes d4, bishop c4, scotch gambit, bishop c5, knight g5. Now, Tarrasch's bishop and knight are both attacking f7 pawn and also c1 bishop is defending g5 knight. Knight h6, defending f7 pawn. Queen h5, attacking f7 pawn again with 3 pieces, castle short, f4. Queen e8, castle short, d3, discover check, king goes to h1, d takes c2, attacking knight, knight jumps to c3. d6, wanted to develop light square bishop, f5, knight jumps to e5, attacking c4 bishop. Instead of playing with bishop, Tarrasch played knight d5, counter-attacking. Tarrasch's plan is knight f6, check, and after g takes f6, queen takes h6, and starting a mate trade against black's king. Black played king h8, mistake. Instead of this mistake, black has to continue with queen d8, f6, bishop g4 attacking queen, queen h4, knight g6 attacking queen, queen g3, and now black's defensive position is better than in the game. But after king's move, Tarrasch played f6 and attacking g7 pawn. Instead of this w's move, Tarrasch has to continue with knight f6. And after g takes f6, queen takes h6, f takes g5, queen f6 check, king g8, queen takes g5. Now if black played knight g6, f takes g6 and white's attack is continuing. If black king goes to h8, Tarrasch has a chance of perpetual check. In the game after f6, black played bishop g4 and this move was blunder. Instead of this move, black has to play knight e to g4 after f takes g7, king takes g7 and black position is better than in the game. After bishop g4, Tarrasch played f takes g7. Now, if black did not take this pawn, king g8, instead of taking free rook, queen takes h6 and there is no defense for mate from h7 square. So in the game, black played king takes g7 and accepted this pawn. Now Tarrasch played queen takes h6. Queen sacrifice. Black has to take this queen because if king goes to g8 or h8, queen takes h7 mate. After this queen sacrifice, king takes h6 and knight e6. Discover check with c1 bishop. In the game, black king goes to h5. If king goes to g6, there is mate in 2. Rook f6, king h5, rook h6 mate. In the game, after king h5, knight d to f4 check again. Now, if king goes to h4, g3 mate. In the game, king goes to h6. Now, knight e2 discover check again. If king goes to h5, there will be mate in 5. Rook f5, sacrificing rook, bishop takes rook, knight g3, king h4, bishop g5, king g4, bishop e2, knight f3, bishop takes knight and mate. In the game, after king goes to g8, Tarrasch sacrificed his second rook, rook f6. Great move. Now if black goes to h5, rook h6 mate. So black took this sacrificed rook and there is a mate in 2. Bishop g5, king has to go g6, knight 2 to f4 and mate. A great performance for famous German master, Doktor Tarash with his minor pieces. Tarash sacrificed both of the major pieces for mating Black King with his minor pieces. If you like this part, like and share this video and subscribe to my channel. See you on later videos. Goodbye.